Hello children, so today in this module we are going to discuss the chapter Indigo by Louis Fisher. Louis Fisher was a famous American journalist who was born in Philadelphia in 1896. This Jewish American journalist was greatly influenced by Gandhiji's use of non-violence and spiritualism as political tool. He came to India in May 1942 and spent 1 week with Gandhiji in his ashram. And there he interviewed him almost every day. So this chapter Indigo is an outcome of that interview where Gandhiji shared his experience in Champaran district and how that one ordinary incident led to a deep experience which brought a turning point in even Gandhiji's life and his movement for an independent India. About the chapter. The chapter Indigo is an excerpt from Louis Fisher's famous book, The Life of Mahatma Gandhi. The writer narrates about Gandhiji's experience and growth as a leader who always fought for the voiceless, downtrodden Indians under oppressive colonial British rule. Indigo is one of the many episodes of Gandhiji's long political struggle. The chapter describes the Champaran visit of Mahatma Gandhi, which was undertaken casually on the request of a poor resolute peasant, Rajkumar Shukla. Gandhiji considered it an ordinary issue and felt that it would last for a few days. But that ordinary looking problem actually occupied almost a year of Gandhi's life. The story describes Gandhiji's struggle to secure justice for oppressed indigo farmers against British planters. Chapter highlights. Rajkumar Shukla persuaded Gandhiji to visit Champaran. During the annual convention of the Indian National Congress Party in Lucknow in 1916, Gandhiji met Rajkumar Shukla, a tenant farmer from Champaran, who requested him to come and see for himself the injustice of the landlord system in Bihar and witness the plight of the farmers. Gandhiji later wrote in his autobiography, "I must confess that I did not then know even the name, much less the geographical position of Champaran, and I had hardly any notion of indigo plantations." Gandhiji told him about his other commitments that were scheduled in various parts of India. But Rajkumar Shukla was so determined that he followed Gandhiji everywhere, and finally, impressed by his determination, Gandhiji accompanied him after his Kolkata visit. Gandhiji's efforts in obtaining concrete information of the situation of Champaran. Now, on the way to Champaran, Gandhiji went to Patna to meet Dr. Rajendra Prasad to get the concrete information of the situation, which Rajkumar Shukla, being illiterate, was not able to provide him. Dr. Rajendra Prasad was one of the lawyers who represented the case of sharecroppers in the court. Due to the lawyer being out of town, Gandhiji had to wait sitting on the ground as servants considered Gandhiji another peasant like Rajkumar due to his simple living and appearance. There, they also did not allow Gandhiji to draw water from the well, thinking him to be an untouchable. There, while waiting for Dr. Rajendra Prasad, Gandhiji got to know about another social evil, untouchability, which was being practiced in Bihar. After that, Gandhiji visited Muzaffarpur to obtain more information about the condition prevalent in the area. He sent a telegram to Professor J.B. Kriplani, who went to receive Gandhiji at the station with a group of students. Gandhiji stayed there for 2 days in the home of Professor Milkani, a government teacher, which was an unusual thing then in colonial India, as people were afraid to show sympathy for advocates of home rule. When the sharecroppers of Champaran came to know about the arrival of Gandhiji for them, they came to Muzaffarpur to meet their champion. Muzaffarpur lawyers met Gandhiji. They told him about their cases and got scolding from Gandhiji when he got to know about the high fee they were charging these poor peasants. Here, Gandhiji realized that the peasants were so crushed and fear-stricken that going to law courts was useless. The real relief for them was to be free from fear first. The sharecropping system in Champaran. Let's understand what that exactly what that system was. Most of the fertile land in Champaran was divided into large states owned by Englishmen and worked by Indian peasants. The chief commercial crop was indigo. The British landlords forced the peasants to plant indigo on 15% of their land and surrender the indigo harvest as rent. In the meantime, Germany had developed synthetic indigo, which was cheaper. British landlords freed the Indian farmers from the 15% of arrangement, but asked them to pay compensation. Some peasants agreed to it and paid the amount, but many others opposed it. Meanwhile, the news of synthetic indigo reached the sharecroppers and they felt cheated and became resentful. They wanted their money back. At this point, Gandhiji had arrived in Champaran. Gandhiji's involvement and his efforts. Gandhiji wanted to confirm the story of the British planters, so he visited the secretary of the British Landlord Association, who refused to provide any information to him. Then he also tried to visit the British commissioner of Tirhut division, who advised him to leave the place. Meanwhile, Gandhiji received information about a farmer being maltreated in Motihari district. Thus, Gandhiji started moving to Motihari. On the way, he was stopped by British officials and had to return later. But he was served with an official notice to leave Champaran, which Gandhiji disobeyed. And defying that, he was summoned to the court. British government's defeat. The news of Gandhiji being summoned spread fast, and then thousands of peasants and influential people of the area gathered there to support Gandhiji and demonstrated in front of the courthouse. This was the beginning of their liberation from fear of the British. The British officials felt powerless before the huge crowd, but Gandhiji helped them to manage the crowd, which evidently proved to people of India and British authorities as well that they are no longer unchallengeable. Without our consent, they can't rule over us. The first triumph of civil disobedience. The prosecutor wanted to postpone the trial, seeing the crowd outside the court. But Gandhiji protested that and read a statement pleading that he was guilty, as he broke the law, but to provide humanitarian service. He also claimed that he respects law, but there is greater respect for the voice of his conscience. The government had to set him free, but they kept the judgment reserved. Rajendra Prasad and other lawyers consulted amongst and told Gandhiji that they would follow him to jail in case he was imprisoned. Gandhiji exclaimed, "The battle of Champaran is won," as the people in Champaran were united then. The Lieutenant Governor dropped the case against Gandhiji, and this was the first triumph of civil disobedience in modern India. Breaking the deadlock. Gandhiji and his associates further conducted an inquiry into the complaints of farmer. He also met the Lieutenant Governor and eventually a committee consisting landlords, government officials, and Gandhiji as the sole representative of peasants was set to proceed the investigation of the matter. A lot of evidence was collected against the landlords, thus leading to refund the money to the peasants. The landlords expected Gandhi to ask for full amount, but he demanded just 50% of the amount to be refunded. Landlords offered him only 25%, and to their amazement, Gandhiji agreed to it. As according to Gandhiji, the amount of refund was less important than the fact that the landlords had been obliged to surrender part of the money and with it part of their prestige. Now the peasants learned that they had rights and they could fight for it. They also learned a lesson of courage, which was much precious than the amount of refund. Within a few years, the British planters abandoned their estates, which returned to the peasants only. Thus, the aged-old indigo sharecropping and landlord system was disrupted and disappeared. Social and cultural backwardness of Champaran. Gandhiji stayed in Champaran for almost 7 months, and by the time he was also aware of the social and cultural backwardness in the village of Champaran. Health conditions were also miserable. He appealed for volunteers to help. Various people came forward for this noble purpose. His wife and his youngest son also arrived to help. Primary schools were opened. Kasturbai taught the women of the village about personal cleanliness and community sanitation. Gandhiji also got a doctor to volunteer his service for 6 months. Champaran episode, a turning point. Champaran episode was a turning point in Gandhiji's life, as his civil disobedience brought British rulers down and also made them realize that Britishers could not order Indians in their own country. A lesson in self-reliance. Louis Fisher further shares one more experience where he tells us that once Charles Freer Andrews, a disciple of Gandhiji, came to bid him farewell before going on a tour of duty to the Fiji Islands. Gandhiji's lawyer friends wanted Gandhiji to stop him, as they thought that an Englishman on their side will make them more strong against the other Englishmen. Gandhiji strongly opposed this suggestion and told them that this showed the weakness of their heart. When the cause was just, they must rely upon themselves. Gandhiji, in this way, taught them a lesson in self-reliance. Now, children, here ends your chapter. In case of any queries, you can drop me your doubts and I would be answering it. Stay safe and stay home. Thank you so much.